What's going on, everybody? I hope all of you are having a wonderful day today. And we are back with some more Pokemon Legends Arceus. Last we left off, we were going to move on to the Coronet Highlands. So we're going to continue on with that. So let's go out here and continue on with the story and see where this leads us. I believe we're going to get a new rideable Pokemon. If I'm correct, we're going to obtain Sneasler. That was awkward. I heard a noise. You probably didn't hear it, but that's okay.
There you are, my boy. Welcome to the Coronet Island. I expect you'll find all sorts of rock-type and ground-type Pokemon wandering about these craggy, boulder-strewn heights. And up there, right beneath the great rift in space-time, is the peak of Mount Coronet itself. The magnetism from it may well exert some sort of influence on the Pokemon throughout the area. Fascinating stuff.
So we gotta make our way up the mountain to Ingo. And so that's this way. So we'll make our way over here. The Electrode, known as the Lord of the Hollow, is somewhat different from the Electrode I recall, but its electric discharges, at least, are familiar. One false step around it could put you in danger. If you're going to face it, you might consider catching Pokemon that can withstand electricity. It must be difficult being a Pokemon, don't you think? Especially one as irritable as Electrode. Then becoming frenzied to boot. So true. It's a tough old life for Pokemon and humans alike. Well, well, Warden Ingo of the Pearl Clan. And, oh my, the Galaxy Team Grunt from before. I was just called a Grunt. And he's not wrong. What is this game? You are punching well above your weight to seek out the great Electrode, Lord of the Hollow. But, by the sheer tenderness of my heart, I will grant you a trial to see if you're worthy. The greatest obstacle you'll ever face awaits you right here. Battle me, if you dare. Oops. Well then, let me tell you the great Melly's take on this whole situation. The frenzy of our nobles is nothing other than a mark of Almighty Sinnoh's favor and protection. Why? Because it makes them stronger. Do I really need to spell out that that's a good thing? We must let my lord frenzy as it may to demonstrate the Almighty Sinnoh that the Diamond Clan lives, as is right and good. This may even be, dare I say it, the very reason I am here on this earth. What business is it of the Galaxy Teams, anyway, if Electrode lets loose a few sparks out here in the mountains? Really? You should do us all a favor and slink back home to that village of yours, rather than persist in this folly. And with that, bon voyage! What a selfish outlook. These frenzies cause the Pokemon themselves such suffering. But what is it you want to do, Gnar? Press on. I want to press on. That's what I want to do. Very well. The tracks ahead will be perilous, but I pride myself on safe driving. To meet Sneasler, Gnar, you must pass through here, Wayward Cave. Here you'll find Pokemon like Golbat and their ilk, which are quite at home navigating in the dark. It's quite dim inside, so you'll need to watch your step. Okay. Inside to the Wayward Cave we go. And we are going to be facing a lot of Zubat and Golbat. Well, this is odd. The torches that light the way through the cave are gone. Could this be Melly attempting to obstruct us? Either way, there's no need for concern. I know my route, and I'll conduct us safely. No darkness nor foul weather will delay us. Onward we roll! Take care not to come uncoupled from me. I mean, on my end, it's not that dark. I recall faintly that I had a partner once, a precious one. Its name escapes me, but I remember that it wielded flames with mastery. If only it were here, I'm sure it would light the way, luring us onward. Please forgive the unscheduled stop. I detect an alpha crobat to our right. Under normal circumstances, I doubt its presence would obstruct someone so competent as you. But given the poor visibility, I propose a track change in the interest of safety. Please follow me. I'm starting to recall a man who looked like me. We battle and discuss Pokemon, I think. The words, "I like winning more than anything else," flashed through my mind just now. We'll soon be arriving at Wayward Cave's exit. Even if the memories themselves have faded, it appears much still lives on in my heart. This is fine progress. We're nearly home free. Wait. Could those be... Hey, it's the torches. Let me put those torches back where they belong. This darkness could be perilous for the next person to pass through here. I beg your pardon for the delay. I have lit and returned the torches. My safety concerns have been addressed. Ready for departure. If you follow the track marked by torches, you'll reach the terminus of this cave. Okay. I can do that. There's a Golbat there. We're just gonna run past everything. And exit out of this cave. Because we're trying to continue the story. Professor Lavendon told me how you fell to this land from the sky. For my part, I simply found myself one day here in Hisui, a region whose name I'd never heard. All I could remember was my own name. I was still standing there in bafflement when the Pearl Clan came to my aid. I showed a natural affinity for taming Pokemon, which is why I eventually became a warden. But still, I wonder what my true purpose is here. Ah, but now I'd sidetracked us with this talk. Let's hurry onward. Alright, which way do I need to go? That way. Nothing can stop me. Onward and upward. Hey, look at the car. Moth? Oh, I got hit. And we're here. What's the big idea? Putting back all the torches I spent ages tidying away? Do you get some sort of amusement stomping around and ruining people's noble deeds? Oh, rendering a cave impassable to people who venture inside hardly seems noble to me. Well, this just goes to show that even we wardens don't always see eye to eye. I extinguished those lights for the sake of the Pokemon in that cave who prefer the dark. But now you louts have put my efforts to waste. If you think I'll just let you saunter ahead to meet Lord Electrode, you're sorely mistaken. The only way you're getting past me is if you defeat my partner Pokemon. I'll beat him. Go, Skuntank. Show these louts the true meaning of silent but deadly. Right, I have the chop at the front. Shouldn't be too much of an issue. Poison jab. That's a lot of it. We'll go ahead. Bullet punch. Switch. I'm gonna switch out for Typhlosion. We're gonna just use Flame Thrower. Because my Typhlosion is currently overleveled. The rest of my team is also decently leveled, but I was using them to unlock more Pokedex stuff. Listen here, neither I nor Skuntank admit defeat just yet. Our challenge to you still stands. However, I will withdraw to afford Skuntank a time to recover. There's no shame in a tactical retreat. It's more of an advance if you think about it. Keep your guard up. We'll be back. What a lively character. I cannot fathom Warden Melly's intentions, but for now, let us press on. Let us continue and press on. Lots of cutscenes. This is the ancient quarry. The stones used to build a temple atop this mountain were all cut from this place. Whether by humans and Pokemon working as one, or by the labor of Pokemon alone, I cannot say. The stones that were left behind should serve to cover us from the gazes of wild Pokemon. Ah, there you are, Ingo. And we got Volo here. Volo, was it? What is the matter, sir? I wanted to ask about that memory loss of yours. Have you considered that it could have somehow been caused by the space-time rift? I have no cause to think the rift is to blame, but then again, I hardly remember a thing, so it's difficult to say with certainty. I can't remember my own home, nor my family, if I had any. So you might do better to pose your questions to Gnar, I think, if it's to do with that rift. Indeed. Well, I do hope your memories return, Warden Ingo. How about you, then, Gnar? Do you remember what you saw before you fell out of that rift? Was there anything inside? Maybe something. Interesting. You see, personally, I suspect that whatever is on the other side of that rift is causing the strange lightning that plagues us. That makes sense. Indeed, I did some digging and found records indicating that the same space-time rift also appeared in Hisui in the distant past. That's why we already had a name for it, as it appeared, in fact. Now, what kind of world do you suppose stretches out on the other side of the rift? My guess is that it is Almighty Sinnoh's realm. But then, that begs the question, why has the space-time rift reopened, when it closed once so long ago? And why would Gnar have fallen through to us? There's just so much we don't know. I fervently hope you unravel this mystery, Volo. I'm sure it would ease people's fears over the frenzies of our nobles. And while you investigate, sir, I'll continue to prioritize the safety of the people living in this world. Oh, I am a mere admirer of ruins and little more. If someone needs investigating, then I would entrust that task to Gnar. Until next time, then. So, we're making some decent and good progress. Once we're through here, it will just be a little further. Let us move with speed, but not haste. Okay. That's a Pokemon. And Bronzors, right? Sometimes I confuse Pokemon names. I'm just gonna keep on moving forward. Not stopping for any Pokemon. At the time, I can always catch Pokemon later. But right now, we are continuing the story. I might pick up a couple of items. Volo wants to set up a camp. We are going here to continue the story by talking to Ingo. You would never expect to be able to climb such sheer cliffs as these, yes? But with Sneasler as an ally, it becomes the work of a moment. She is so at home on a cliff face, one might think she knew some secret, some hidden move. What am I saying? Hidden moves? There are no such thing in Hisui, surely. There is also apparently no such thing in the modern Pokemon. Yet I feel as though I was on the cusp of remembering something just now. Just who was I before I came to Hisui? If you fell from the sky, you come from another world altogether, most likely. Perhaps a Pokemon battle with you would jog this memory loose. Would you honor me with a battle, Gnar? Yeah. We can do that. All aboard, then. Machoke, prepare for departure. He's got three Pokemon. He sent out Machoke. We're going to send out Typhlosion. It shouldn't be too hard to win this fight against Aerial Ace. I'm still a little surprised that Typhlosion can learn Aerial Ace. I don't believe that it's possible. Super effective. And it kicks back twice? Come on. So we're gonna go ahead and flamethrower. Did a lot of damage and it was burned. But if it gets to attack again, Typhlosion is likely going to fail. Which is fine. We will just revive Typhlosion in a bit. We're gonna go ahead and send out my Alpha Slyther. I almost called him Slyther. Slyther, the Sky Dragon. Ooh, he's ominous. What's his third Pokemon? Angler. Exorcism. That should do a ton of damage. Winning me this battle. Bravo! Excellent! Your talent has brought you the destination called victory. Now, allow me to call Sneasler. Let's call Sneasler. Allow me to introduce you, Gnar. This keen clawed Pokemon is Sneasler. Would you be so kind as to play your flute for her to hear? Yes, of course I would. Not that the sound is any different, but Pokemon can somehow tell the difference. Sneasler opened her heart and learned well the sound of your playing. You have received the toxic plate from Sneasler. I'm afraid this is my final stop. Please proceed up the cliff with Sneasler's aid and quell the Lord up in the mountains. I will return to Jubilife Village. Please convey my well wishes to Warden Melly. Now then, all aboard! You can now call Sneasler to scale and descend sheer cliffs and rock faces. You can climb up and down cliffs, ledges, and other sheer surfaces with Sneasler's aid. To summon Sneasler, press the A button when you're near a climbable surface, or use the plus button in any other location. Before that, we're going to revive Typhlosion. And heal both Typhlosion and Machop. And we're going to climb. Actually, we'll pick up a couple items here. It's a pretty neat and interesting that Sneasler just puts you in a box. So we're going over here. We're going to ignore all Pokemon at the time. At this time. Stantler. Back to Sneasler. I said Stantler, but it's Weirdeer. And I got stuck on that ledge. Nice. The Alpha statues. Back to Sneasler. We're just climbing up some cliffs. Well, I'm in a box. I'm gonna catch Pokemon that I have not caught yet in the future. But for now, like I said, we are continuing the story so we can eventually get to the end of this game. Welcome to Moonview Arena, the seat of Lord Electrode. I know I've not exactly been supportive of you reaching this place, but a part of me did hope you'd make it. Call me contradictory if all you like, Galaxy Grunt, but such is life. Embracing the complexity of both ourselves and the world can only help us grow. As a member of the Diamond Clan, my highest calling is to please Almighty Sinnoh. And right now, that means I must protect my lord by stopping you where you stand. If you still wish to defeat me and gain entry to Electrode's seat, you and your little Pokemon are welcome to give it your best shot. Let's go, Skuntank. Give them another whiff of your silent deadliness. You realize you're gonna lose it, right, Melly? Oh, you've got three Pokemon out at this time. So we're gonna flamethrower this Zubat. No, it's the Skuntank that we're gonna flamethrower. I thought we were targeting this Zubat. My bad. So we're gonna fight a super effective dark type versus ghost type. Zubat's gonna use Gust. I'm gonna go ahead and bounce against Zubat. Yet again. And we'll go ahead and use Flamethrower. Why would you use level 22? He tried to team up on me with three of his Pokemon, but that didn't work. Let's make one thing clear. I didn't lose. You may have won, but there's a difference. No, not really. No difference. I just lacked, time. Yes, I'm afraid there simply wasn't enough time for me to raise my Pokemon nice and strong. Ah, could this be why Ataman is always going on and on about time being a precious thing? My word! The Diamond Clan and Almighty Sinnoh truly are never-ending fountains of wisdom. That sounded so awkward to say because of how I said it. Yes, yes. I know what comes next. You want to know what pleases Lord Electrode so you can make some bombs for it. Well, I'm afraid I won't be able to help you. Because I have completely forgotten what Electrode likes. Aren't you, an idiot? What's the matter? Upset? Too bad anger doesn't make bombs. Melly's really giving you the runaround, isn't he, Gnar? I guess it's my fault for not telling you in advance what Electrode likes. So here's the... Adamon! What now? I could hear you just now, you know. Are you really going to tell this little noodle what he needs to find? Just like that? Lest we all forget, you're the leader of the Diamond Clan. Why do you bother with these galaxy louts? Use your eyes, Melly. Haven't you even looked at your frenzied lord? Don't you feel even a twinge at how it suffers, fighting to control the energy that's bursting out of it? I see nothing but a Pokemon overcome with joy at being among Almighty Sinnoh's chosen ones. Anyway, it's not like trials and suffering are always cause for doom and gloom. These things exist to help us grow. I'm sorry, Melly. I can't write off these frenzies as some trial from Almighty Sinnoh. That's why I'm doing the best I can to help out Gnar here. This is bigger than what team or clan we belong to. Oh, and by the way, I wasn't just going to tell him that he needs crunchy salt. I was going to go right ahead and give it to him. Now it's time to make some bombs, so lend a hand, both of you. Fine, at the end of the day, let none say that the great Melly shirked his duties as warden. I'll help make your precious bombs. Not bad. Melly's coming around to help out here. There, I made you a practically infinite supply of bombs, so chuck all you like at Electrode. But don't underestimate my lord's strength. I very much doubt the likes of you can quell it. I'll be able to quell it. It's not going to be an issue. Because I am a Pokemon master. So, even knowing you were doomed to fail, you still wish to pit yourself against Electrode? I'm ready to battle. Huh. You've a great deal more pluck than you have sense. I'll give you that. A word of advice? Don't stop moving while you're battling Electrode, or you'll be dead in no time. Yeah, I mean, it's kind of a given. That's what I figured already, but we're gonna quell Electrode because it's what I have to do. It's big! The big round boy! And it's upside down. Lord of the Hollow, Electrode. This is gonna be pretty easy. Oh, I hit. Wrong button to dodge. Closely. No, stay away from me. All right, go Typhlosion.
Thunder Wave. And I got hit by it, not just my Pokemon. Typhlosion is paralyzed, and maybe. Typhlosion is paralyzed. That's not good. At least it avoided the attack. Typhlosion, stop being paralyzed! Attack the Electrode. You're paralyzed to the point where you can't attack. Sure, dodge move. Battle's being a little bit harder than all the previous ones. Because those homing electric attacks are kind of really hard to deal with. They're hard to make disappear. And if you are able to make them disappear, I'm not sure. We are almost home free. A little bit more. Come on. Almost. Almost. It was quelled. I got hit right at the end there, too. Luckily, I didn't black out there and have to redo this fight. But we have quelled the Lord of the Hollow Electrode. And leveled up some of my Pokemon. We got the Zap Plate from Electrode. Oh, for shame. What utter calamity. I agreed to make those accursed bombs, yes, but now the almighty Sinnoh's precious blessing has vanished forever. It's just so unbearably sad. Is that how you see it? Electrode looks relieved to me, glad its suffering's ended. Probably. Oh, come on, Ataman. Seriously? That's just your wishful thinking, nothing more. All your preaching doesn't ruffle me one bit, but if Almighty Sinnoh grows angry with me because of this, I don't know what I'll do. I arrive, right on schedule. Now, what did you bother coming back for? Only to say that I recalled some things after Nar did me the honor of traveling with me. Things to do with a world where I believe I lived before my memories were lost. Most people there caught Pokemon, lived with them, formed supportive partnerships with them. And then there were the Pokemon trainers. The ones we called Pokemon trainers were truly devoted to their craft. They always looked toward the next challenge and had Pokemon battles every chance they got. All to help themselves and their Pokemon grow. Through battle, trainers forged bonds of understanding with their Pokemon, and with their opponents and their Pokemon too. With everything, I suppose. If Pokemon and people work together, we can forge new paths forward. We'll be lost to history if we go on believing only Pokemon can be strong. or if we go on fearing them instead of understanding them. Interesting. Was your world like Ingo described Tunar?
It sure was.
I'd never have thought such a world could exist. Oh, once again, the brilliant Warden Melly has realized something rather clever. It's not just my Pokemon that need to be strong, it's me as well. The greater my valor and might, the more my Pokemon can reach their potential. I wonder if Almighty Sinnoh will be pleased once I've achieved exactly that. Hey Adama, share with me again the wisdom of Almighty Sinnoh passed down among our clan.
Alright, open your ears, shut that big mouth, and listen well, my friend. Give not into sorrow, give not into anger, offer only friendship to those around you. Give not into sorrow, give not into anger, bring not Almighty Sinnoh to sorrow. For that is when time's flow will cease. And there you have it.
Bravo! Excellent! Please, all of you, do your best and run toward the destination, an even higher state. Of course, your higher state is clear, Gnar. It surely lies with the next lord. Now, this time, I really will make the complete return trip to Jubilife Village. Perhaps with someone like Gnar to show that Pokemon need not be feared, the people of Hisui will find new tracks forward. Now, begging your pardon, I owe Commander Kamado my report. Until next time, Gnar.
That's me.
Can we find a way to honor our past while also forging a better future? Maybe that's what Almighty Sinnoh really wants from us. After all, it rules over all time, and it creates everything there is. Be ready to shield your eyes, Galaxy Grunt. I'm going to polish up both myself and Electrode until our strength and brilliance are blinding. I am stumbling over some words. So, let's see. There's that. But what they want me to do is go back to the town. I caught that Pokemon a while ago. Oh, it seems you've made some new observations. Let's have a look then.
Mm-hmm. I see. Most illuminating. I'll update our Pokedex with new data.
Here we got all of those. So let's go back. We got some points.
Oh, you've quelled Lord Electrode. Splendid job as always, my boy. Let's be off to the village then. Time to report to Commander Kamado.
Yes. Time to report my deeds of quelling Lord Electrode. That is exactly what we'll do. We'll do that, and that's going to be the end of the video after we talk to Kamado. And we will pick up quelling the next noble Pokemon in the next episode after we finish talking to Kamado here.
So Warden Melly believes that the frenzies of these Pokemon are some sort of trial set by Almighty Sinnoh. We cannot know if that is the case or not, but it does beg the question. Why ever would this Almighty Sinnoh drive the nobles to frenzy? Is it angered by something, or does it seek to drive a wedge between people and Pokemon? Well, far be it from us humans to fathom the thoughts of Pokemon. And what is that space-time rift anyway? What caused it to open? But you must be tired. Go on then, to the Wallflower. Get some rest while you can. I've instructed Benny to prepare you his finest potato mochi.
Scaling perilous heights complete.
off to the wallflower!
Dinner's on Kamado tonight. Eat your fill.
What an enticing aroma! My appetite just went through the roof!
Quite a change from the commander's usual preaching about tightening our belts until things grow more stable.
Well, I've heard talk that our progress surveying Pokemon has made gathering ingredients a less onerous, or at least dangerous, task.
It's almost like a fairy tale, isn't it? How you've fallen to us from the sky and gone on to help the people of Hisui so much.
Indeed. Taking on such perilous duties has earned you a great deal of trust, Na. It's like I always say, behavior is a mirror that reflects one's true nature. You let your actions do the speaking for you, Na. And the message is clear as day. It doesn't matter one whit where you came from. You're part of the Survey Corps in Jubilife Village now.
Let's eat the potato mochi.
And go to bed.
The next day.
Isn't it nice getting up early? Is it? It's not as if getting up early changes what you can do with the day. Yes, it does. It opens up possibilities, such as responding to Commander Kamado's invitation today in a timely manner. Well, I got the same invitation, and I had to wake up even earlier than you to run all the way here for it. Come on, no need to grouse so much over a nice little early wake up. Are you coming too? I'm sure we can all guess what the commander wants with us. Yes, do come. Galaxy Hall is quite close anyway.
You've now quelled the frenzy of four nobles.
It wasn't easy.
When word of these frenzies arrived from all over Hisui, I feared what would become of us. But here we are, already preparing to quell the final noble.
Yeah. Who would have dreamed some stranger who tumbled out of the sky would be our salvation? Life never does stop surprising you.
The only lord left to be quelled is Avalug, which lives in the Alabaster Icelands. He is also the largest of the nobles, according to what Arita told me. Your mission is to quell Avalug, the final lord. And perhaps in doing so, we may trigger some change in the space-time rift as well.
Avalug may be the Pearl Clan's noble, but my clan and the Galaxy team will have to step up to resolve this too. For the sake of a brighter future. Then, let us all meet in the cold reaches of the Alabaster Icelands. Until then,
we'll activate the guide for that.
No matter how many of these frenzied Pokemon you may quell, the fact remains that you are a stranger to our world. No small number of people still regard you with suspicion and distrust. The most you can hope for is to gain the trust of as many as possible, and to do that, you must prove yourself through your actions.
I mean, that's what I'm trying to do.
Yeah!
Huh? Oh. Abra! Teleport this Whirlpool outside at once!
Does Abra have that capability? I knew Abra can teleport itself.
Ahem.
So, you're ready to survey the Alabaster Icelands next.
This is the most treacherous climb you'll face in all of Hisui. It would not be an exaggeration to say that you might be the only one among the Survey Corps I can task with surveying the Alabaster Icelands. You know your orders. See your mission through.
And with that, that's going to be the end of today's video. Thank you all so much for watching. I appreciate every single one of you. And, well, we'll pick up with this in the next part. But for now, I will see all of you in the next video. Until then, please take care.